Hello and welcome back to our channel.
Welcome back to our channel. So today is the long-awaited home tour. So
Troy has been dying to film this, so I finally agreed to it. Yeah. We still have some things that we're working on and want to get completed, but we figured why not just show you guys where we're at now.
Yeah, we can always give you guys updates of things that we do later on. And disclaimer, we are not home designers, and we don't claim to be. I think we get a lot of our ideas from YouTube too, so.
I classify myself as an interior designer.
Yeah, so, and we also know that like our style isn't for everyone, so.
If you don't like it, that's fine.
Yeah,
but hopefully you guys get some ideas. Awesome, yeah. Fabulous.
Yeah, so like I said, we get a lot of our ideas from YouTube and online, so hopefully you guys get some ideas and yeah. What?
You just smile at me when you talk, it's cute. All right, let's take you around.
All right, welcome to MTV Cribs. I was dying to say that, Sam told me I couldn't, so.
Yeah, so probably shouldn't say that again. So this is the front entryway of our house. We have a map behind me of our city, and let's move on over here into Troy's office.
Yeah, so I'll put pictures up on the screen of what places looked like before, so.
So this is our dog crate that Troy actually built. He got the idea off Pinterest, and I can't tell you how many people think like it's just a decor piece. So, really gorgeous, did a really good job. Obviously his desk, I'm not sure where you got any of this.
Yeah, so the desk and the little, I don't even know what you would call that back there. Those are both from Target.
Bookshelf.
Yeah, the little bookshelf, those are both from Target. And then I got this picture. So this is of the racetrack near our house. I got that online. This is a recliner actually, the chair behind Sam. That is from Wayfair. The light is from Target. And then back there, got a couple pictures. So that's actually, that's my grandpa, that's me and my uncle, all of us when we were in the Air Force.
And
so.
This is me and Troy from our engagement shoot. Shout out Cassie. All right, let's move on to our dining room. So here's our dining room. So this table set Troy actually got before I even moved in. This was literally the only thing that was in the dining room when I moved in.
Yeah, so the table set's from Walmart, and as you can see, we got a walkthrough here. Oh, well, Adelaide's gonna have dinner at it. So we put a bench here because you gotta kind of walk through here to get to the rest of the house, so it makes the most sense. And as you guys can see over here, the cats have already done a number on it, so.
The what? Oh, you're talking about the chair.
Yep.
And then this plant over here is actually a plant that's normally outside on the back patio during the summertime, but since it's obviously starting to get to be winter up here, so now it's inside.
Yep.
This wall was absolutely massive, is absolutely massive. So we kind of had to find something that was gonna fill up the entire wall. Before, Troy had like these ugly stars on the wall. But now we have these beautiful pieces from HomeGoods.
Yes, these are from HomeGoods.
Marshalls.
Then this is our centerpiece we did. So this took us a little longer than you'd think to come up with. So the sign, actually everything there we found at
TJ Maxx. Besides the pampas grass. The pampas grass literally came right from a park.
Yeah, a park right near our house. So, and like Sam said, that plant's normally outside. It's not the most good looking.
Fake plant is from Target. And same with the basket. So yeah, I've always seen these plants like in other people's YouTube videos. So I've always wanted one. So I think this was actually more expensive. I think this plant was like $130, which is kind of expensive for like a fake plant, but it's really nice. And people tend to think that it's real, even though we're in upstate New York, we wouldn't have those type of plants.
And yeah, so it's a little more expensive, but you don't have to worry about killing it because it's fake.
All right, let's just move into like this like middle area, I guess you would say. So this is like dining room, kitchen, and then this is like just like a little walkway into our living room. But over here, We have these two blue chairs that Troy also had before I moved in. But I think they're from Kohl's, right?
Yeah, they're from Kohl's. And ideally, we would like cream color chairs eventually to like kind of go with the rest of our decor, but they're not bad right now. And
we're not in a rush to get different chairs because my cats like to scratch on everything.
Yeah, you can see a little bit right here.
And then this little bar cart, you got from Craigslist.
Yeah, Craigslist. So a lady was actually selling this. So it's pretty cool. So you can see it's got wine, a couple cabinets. We hang our wine glass on there. And then this middle part actually opens up and there's a cutting board inside. So it's really designed to be a bar. We don't really use the top that much, but I think it was like less than $100. But yeah, it was on Craigslist.
Same thing with the pampas grass idea. We got that from the park, and we got this like really pretty white ceramic vase from, this is one of our older vases. I'm pretty sure it's from TJ Maxx Home Goods.
Yes, yep.
And then this was also from Home Goods, this art piece back here.
Yeah, so I don't know if you guys can see it in there, but it's actually like a little bit thicker, so it's like a shadow box. It's kind of dimensional, so it was a little bit more expensive, but it's exactly the style we like, so.
So this is our kitchen. So we also forgot to mention that this is not our house that we're planning on spending the rest of our lives in. We expect to see ourselves moving and building within the next 5 years, but this is definitely a really good house for us, like starting a family and yada yada yada. But this high top table Troy and his mom got from Craigslist as well.
Yep, Craigslist. So this is actually just primer, believe it or not. So the guy had primed it and he was gonna paint it, but we liked it just like it was, and it had a really cool look that way. So,
and then this basket here was from Target, and this little vase was from Amazon, and this, I don't even know what you cut, flowers?
Yeah, it's just kind of like straw or
I got
something.
That from TJ Maxx.
Yep.
And then this is our kitchen. There's really not much to it. Our next big project of the house is probably gonna be new cabinets, just because these were the cabinets that were already in the house prior, and Troy just painted over them to make them white for the time being until we do put in new cabinets. But yeah, there's not.
That's definitely one of the last major things we want to do in the house, is get new cabinets.
Yeah.
So we plan on doing that. Like Sam said, it's not our forever home, so we're not going to rearrange this. Like, it is a little like, you know, it's not a ton of space. Like, you can't really have an island in here, which we want. But
I want a big island.
Yeah.
So
yep.
We'll get it when the time comes.
Yep. And then back there, that's just, that's just our laundry room. So that actually goes out to like where our garage is. That's where the cat's stuff is. And yeah, nothing too exciting over there.
Yada, yada, yada.
But we're gonna try and link everything. And if there's nothing that, you know, like for example, this is from Craigslist, like Sam said. If we can't link it below, then we'll try and find something that is similar, so you guys can see that, so. All right, moving on.
To the living room.
All right, moving on to the living room.
So this is our comfy space. I would classify our style as minimalistic, but also really cozy. So this coffee table was a Restoration Hardware inspired coffee table that Troy built. We were really looking for like a vintage-y look coffee table, and he absolutely nailed it. If you wanna get closer so they can see the texture and everything. So obviously, we really like Home Goods and TJ Maxx. Those are definitely like our favorite places to shop for home decor. This big vase was actually maroon. Troy spray painted that. This was from Home Goods. These olive branches are from Hobby Lobby. This like tree branch looking thing, Home Goods. And then these books and this crystal, also Home Goods.
Yep.
So,
and then most of our pillows, they're all messed up right now. Most of our pillows are, most of them are from TJ Maxx. And then kind of the same thing, like we would love to have, kind of like the chairs, we would love to have like a cream color couch, but like Sam just said, with the dogs and especially with it being wet in winter and them just being crazy as they are, we wouldn't really be able to keep it clean. So we like our couch and it wasn't too crazy expensive, so.
And that's another thing too, is like our back door to go outside where we let the dogs out is literally right in the living room. So it'd be pointless for us to get a nice couch for this room. Maybe in the near future when we have a different house and we have like two living rooms, one family room, we'll get like a cream colored couch for one of those rooms. But for now, this couch does us good. Nice and comfy.
Yep.
And didn't break a bank.
Yeah, the couch is from
Big Lots.
Yep, Big Lots. So I looked this up today. Big Lots are in 47 states, so.
Oh, really?
Everyone has Big Lots. That picture up there is from TJ Maxx. I got it in actually a different place, so.
I was laughing because Mila, one of my cats, is meowing. And then this big lamp thing is from Target.
And they still have that.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure this is kind of, we thought it was gonna be a little bit more expensive than it actually was out. I want to say it was like $80.
Yeah, I think it was $80, and it's near the Studio McGee. If you go to Target enough, you'll know exactly what we're talking about.
This little round circular mirror was also Big Lots. I got this for my apartment when I was living in my apartment, and I think that was like really cheap. That was like $20. So this little area over here, we have these two, I don't even remember what these are called.
Lanterns.
Lanterns.
Those are from...
We got these two lanterns from IKEA.
Yep.
What price?
I don't remember. We'll link them though. They still have them.
Do they have them on the website?
I think so. I know they still have them in store. Last time we were there.
So this top part of our TV area, we had a very difficult time designing, but we finally figured out our vibe of what our house wanted to be, what we wanted our house to be like. So we got everything up here is from. No, actually, this Magnolia table book is from Target.
Yep, Magnolia table, you guys have probably seen that.
We have the white Magnolia candle and the crystal, both from HomeGoods. And then all of these pieces up here, these little vases, the M from McCullen, and then these beads are from Hobby Lobby. This area down here is like where literally when any of my friends come over ask where these big pampas grass are from. This is actually from Pier 1. I believe they all went out of business.
Yeah, most of them went out of business. So you can order it online. It's a little pricey. It's pricey in general. So we paid about $12 per stock. So there's four there and we have them in our bedroom like you guys will see. You can order them online. They're probably gonna be even more expensive than that though.
Yeah. This blanket ladder, Troy built, crafty man I have. This blanket is from IKEA?
Primark, yeah, Primark in Boston.
And then we have this basket that we just put all of our blankets in, variety of different blankets, but the basket is from HomeGoods. Let's go over to our bedroom. So this is our gorgeous bedroom and our gorgeous dogs that should not be on our beds since we have white bedding, but they are on it anyways. Can you relax, please? So our headboard, no, I should say our bed frame is from IKEA.
Yeah, it's a whole bed frame. And warning, we'll link it. If you guys get this, you do need to buy the legs with it.
Yeah, the legs come separately. We did talk about that in a vlog. When we did go to IKEA, we got home and we realized there were no legs in it. So Troy was able to put together some legs to put on the bed.
Yep.
Our nightstands, I could not tell you where they're from.
They're from Taft Furniture. So that's a local place, I believe. So you guys probably won't have it. We'll link something similar.
I believe it's a brand that a lot of furniture stores have, though. So if you can find them, we'll link them.
Yep.
We have these mirrors, these tall mirrors above our nightstands. Lowe's?
Yes, those are just from Lowe's, just basic mirrors. They're actually really, really inexpensive.
Mm-hmm. And then we got these really pretty lamps. If you get up close, they're like a glass see-through.
Yeah, it looks like it's like broken glass almost.
They're really pretty. And
yep.
This is my side of the bed.
Yep. And then above the bed, so... This was actually spin art. So Sam and I bought this canvas because it was the perfect size because we couldn't find a piece that fit the area. So we bought this canvas from Michaels And then we did spin art on it. So you guys have probably seen that on social media, really, really popular. And it came out cool, but it wasn't really our vibe. So I ended up painting over the entire thing white. And then I used joint compound. So for all my guys, you'll know what that is. It's the stuff you...
all the girls, you won't know what that is.
unless you're handy. And then really I just spread it all over so you can kind of see it's textured. It's the stuff you fill holes in on the wall with, and spread it all over. And then I just spray painted with like some antique white spray paint. All right, and then this is my side of the bed. So same lamp, I have the Homebody book. So Chip and Joanna Gaines again, a little crystal. I got this thing from TJ Maxx, so I just put my jewelry in there, but it actually had a lid with like a butterfly on it, and I just ditched the lid to have it as a little tray. Then over here, we have another tall vase, just like we have in the living room, and the pompous grass again. So where did we get the tall vases from?
TJ Maxx.
All right, so.
Actually, TJ Maxx, not a Home Goods.
Yeah.
So this area over here is still to be determined. We still haven't figured out what we want in this corner. We have a few things in mind. We're thinking about just like a big chair. We're thinking about a bookshelf, like a glass bookshelf, and styling that, but we just haven't figured it out. So right now we just have the two dog beds there.
Yep.
For the time being, and then this mirror.
The mirror is from IKEA.
Yeah.
These two pictures here, these are from
Target.
This is my bathroom, so this is off our bedroom. So this is mostly mine, so not too creative on the decorating.
Could you try again?
Oh, my watch is talking to me. Not too creative on the decorating, so everything in here is from Target. One day I literally had nothing in my bathroom. I bought that stuff to make it look somewhat decorated.
Yeah. I don't tend to use that bathroom.
All right, headed over to the other side of our house. So this is Sam's area over here.
So this is my bathroom. I made it pretty minimal, and I just wanted it to be like white and green and some pops of gray. Normally there is a bath mat on the ground, but it's dirty, so it is what it is. I got these two pieces from TJ Maxx, this little plant from Target, and yeah, I mean, I don't have much in it. I'm just trying to keep it simple.
That pumpkin, the one remaining fall decoration in our house.
I also have a pumpkin on the garbage.
Oh, and then she just uses these little mason jars.
Which are empty.
Just for, what are those called? Cotton pads, Q-tips, stuff like that.
Yeah, so. I normally have full thing of Q-tips, but last time I went to Target, I forgot the Q-tips.
And Sam, she puts her towels just in a little basket near her shower.
I think it's really cute.
Yep.
All right, let's go over to the guest room.
This is our guest room, so this is pretty much off limits most of the time.
Yeah, so this is where whenever I have friends over for the weekend, or Troy occasionally has friends over for the weekend, normally it's my friends. But yeah, so this is where they sleep. A lot of this stuff, I swear, you cannot jump on every single bed. So this white comforter is a Ralph Lauren comforter. I actually think it's a down comforter, so we're gonna have to put a duvet cover on it eventually. Those pieces came from my old apartment that I had. I got those at Big Lots and they were like $30. So that was a really good buy, and I think it's really cute for here because we're just trying to keep this room clean. We have these two nightstands.
So funny story about these nightstands. Sam and I actually had each one of these before we were together. And then when we moved in together, we now had two of them. Yeah. So
we put them on both sides of bed. Those are from TJ Maxx.
Headboard is from Amazon, I believe. Yeah. Really inexpensive. I think it was like less than $100. So
yeah, really affordable. I'm pretty sure it was like $90.
Yeah.
I just have this cat tower. My girl's favorite thing. And then we just have this corner. That's actually a closet in there. I keep all my sweatshirts. Well, most of my sweatshirts. I do have sweatshirts elsewhere around the house. But we have our Wi-Fi up there for when our guests come. This little plant is from TJ Maxx. The chair you got from where?
That's from Kohl's too, I believe. And then the little table and everything on the table are from Target. So that table is a little more expensive than it should be. So I will say with duvet covers, so not something we talked about in our bedroom, but we went through like so many comforters at first with having the dogs and them jumping on it. And you know, we just have a lot of animals. So duvet covers.
That's what happens when you have four animals.
They're kind of a pain in the butt to put in the comforter inside the cover, but it's so worth it. So you're not washing or ruining comforters all the time. You just slip the duvet cover right over it. So our comforter and our cover are both from IKEA. So highly recommend. It's a little bit of initial investment, but it's so much better than ruining comforters.
And the thing is too, is that if you have animals, I wouldn't recommend getting a white comforter, period. But I mean, if you are good with keeping your dogs off the bed, then that's fine. But
as
we're
we are.
Not. So.
Yeah, so the duvet cover is awesome. Yeah.
We like white, but we wash our stuff a lot. We do laundry like twice a week.
This is where the magic happens.
So this is where I do my makeup and I get changed. I have these custom drawers here from IKEA. I just have like written down books here. I'm kind of thinking and considering about just like restyling this. I kind of think it's just at this point like a little too young for me. So I'm thinking about just getting a little bit of a different vibe around here. But these books are all from Target. I got this little plant. From where did we get this one? Home Goods?
Yeah, I think so.
Everything Home Goods. Home Goods or go home. This also from Home Goods, just holds some of my jewelry, candles.
Where are the pictures from?
Oh, the pictures are from Hobby Lobby. Surprisingly, so many people ask me where this mirror is from. It's a shorter mirror. It did well when I was living in my apartment, but these walls or these ceilings are just a little bit higher. So I do want to eventually just get like a plain, really tall, just plain mirror. But this mirror is from Burlington.
Burlington Coat Factory.
Yeah, so, and that was super cheap. That was only like $50.
So that somewhere you would never look for a mirror.
What'd you say?
You'd never look for a mirror at Burlington.
No, my mom told me, I didn't even know they had home decor. But my mom told me, go in there, they do have some home decor pieces. So I finally did it and I got that mirror. So yeah, then I just have this clothing rack here. I just have like some of my, right now, since we're going into fall, winter, no, we're almost out of fall. It's almost Christmas season. So I just have some of my favorite sweaters on here, my jean jackets, and just some black sweatshirts, as well as just some like graphic sweatshirts down there, and just some of my booties, like my booties that I wear on a more daily basis. Then over here, I also just have these two art prints from Hobby Lobby. I have the same gray chair that's in the guest room, but I just have it covered over with a white fur blanket. And then I just have, these are called the Alex drawers, I'm pretty sure. From IKEA, I have this makeup organizer from TJ Maxx. These two makeup brush holders, also TJ Maxx Home Goods. This little table here was from Amazon. I should have just gotten the one at IKEA because it made more sense and it would have matched better. But yeah, this does the job. This was, Troy found this actually, because if you look for any of these type of mirrors, they're expensive. They run from like $300 to $500 and it's just obnoxious.
Yeah, and a lot of the ones you'll find online, this is something you gotta be really careful for. They all look like they have these types of bulbs, but they're actually like really tiny like LED bulbs and they don't look like the old fashioned beauty bulbs. So.
Yeah.
I don't remember where we ended up getting this. I think it was like a really weird website.
You found it. He found it on Amazon, but it took him to a different website.
Yeah, it was a foreign website.
The
brand is Posh.
Yeah, so look up POSH. Maybe you can find it. Maybe not.
Yeah, this was from at least a year ago.
Yeah.
Last Christmas,
maybe? Actually, I was on my Snapchat. I got this just around this time.
Okay.
I got it around November 1st.
Perfect. So clear chairs from IKEA.
Yep.
These are also a little bit harder to find, but you can find them online. They're a little pricey. That's why we went with the IKEA one. So.
Yeah. And then I just have this bookshelf from IKEA as well. Just have a little bit of pieces, decor pieces on it. I do still have some pumpkins in here, which I gotta change. We're setting up Christmas in this household this weekend. So I'm really excited to get the Christmas pieces up. But yeah, this is what I have for now. And then I just have this art piece too. My Aunt Kathy got this for me. And that was also from TJ Maxx. So yeah, that's this room. And then this is where the magic happens for the girls. It's where their litter box is.
If you do have dogs and cats, These are a lifesaver. So we have a little, you can buy these on Amazon specifically meant for this. So it keeps the door from opening too much so the dogs can't get in the litter box.
Yeah, because the dogs tend to like to eat cat poop. So yeah, that's our house, our gorgeous house that we've taken forever to decorate and find our style in. It's literally taken us probably 10 months to figure out.
All right, we want to take you guys through the house because we are transitioning from all our fall decor to Christmas.
Yep.
And winter, so you guys will be seeing that very soon. And hopefully you guys got some ideas. We'll try and link everything we can below. If there's something we missed, just comment or reach out to us and we'll find you it or something similar. And yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed. And
get ready for the Christmas vlogs. They're coming.
Yeah.
And they're coming fast.
We'll catch you guys next time. Hope you enjoyed.
Like and subscribe.
Bye.
Think about it. There must be a higher